Welcome to Mature Living. I'm Mary Yanez, director of the Senior Adult Program, and you're going to enjoy this show because you're going to learn about some of the great things that are happening in El Paso. And one of them is our dear friend, Elizabeth Reda, who is a co-writer and editor of the Herencia magazine, which is Heritage magazine. And she'll be writing an English section for this magazine. Elizabeth, tell me a little bit about what you've been doing with your husband, of course, Wesley Cordova. Tell me about this magazine and how long he's been producing this.
Well, this magazine has been in El Paso for 5 years.
Yes.
5 whole years. So we've made a difference for 5 years in El Paso. And we are growing and we want to make it stronger in El Paso. We want to bring more people into the community and reading. It's very important to read.
Absolutely. And reading good things. I love the theme of in Spanish is La gratitud es la memoria del corazón, which means
the gratitude is the memory of the heart.
And you know, many of the seniors love the sound of opening the newspaper.
Yes.
And reading positive articles. And I also love the fact that this magazine brings only good news.
Absolutely.
Healthy and just good things that seniors, you know, there's so much negative in the world that we really need.
Exactly. And it's family friendly. We don't have any ideas that are negative. Everything is positive. Everything is fulfilling and inspirational.
Yes. Absolutely. And that's what the articles are about.
Yes.
Now tell me a little bit also where we can find this magazine.
You can find it at different places on Alameda, at La Chinampa, Loma Land Bakery as well.
Yes.
A lot of restaurants have
and
it.
And if people want this free magazine to pick up, can they call you to give you more sites?
Yes.
Maybe they know of their favorite restaurant and they want it there, you know.
Yes, they can call me at 915-248-7017. Yes. Absolutely.
And what about this issue? And then we'll talk about a previous issue that you did that I just love and you're going to show us. What about gratitude?
Well, we're coming to the festive days, and we have to remember that we have to be grateful for whether we have a lot or we have a little bit. And it's a time to bless our seniors as well.
Yes.
This is the time that they need a lot of attention.
Yes.
So our articles are geared for gratitude and to be thankful for what we have.
One of the things that comes to mind during the holiday season is many seniors are isolated, they're lonely, their families, you know, maybe they've outlived their husband or wife, their partner, and the kids live out of town, and they're alone, they're lonely. So this is a time when neighbors or church people.
Yes.
Can invite a senior to their homes for Thanksgiving or for Christmas celebrations. That's a great thing to do.
I do hope that they do that, and I hope this issue inspires them to do stuff like that. They need to come as a community.
Yes.
And help out our seniors.
Talking about help, you've always helped the Senior Adult Program. You've been in our plays.
Oh.
You've been in our pageants. And so thank you for bringing a little bit of positiveness into our world. I really appreciate it. And I'm glad you're going to be writing because I've got some ideas for
thank you.
To,
thank you
to
so
write
much.
About. Tell me about some previous issues.
Well, we're very proud of this one. This one is a tribute for Juan Gabriel.
Yes.
We rewrote beautiful stuff on him, and we gave it to him. We honored him.
You honored him.
Yes.
And
absolutely.
That is so great. Tell me about the main editor, your husband, Wesley. Tell me about his work and some of the groups and the support groups that he does.
Well, Wesley Cordova right now has a group on Mondays, and anybody is invited. It's a diversified community. People from all walks of life, we get together and he inspires us, gives us positive, motivational thinking.
Yes. And you know, I know you've had some very interesting cases where a woman was passing by and saw the group and stopped by and she was contemplating suicide. And because of that inspiration and being part of that group, she changed her mind.
Absolutely.
That is amazing.
It is. And she's a beautiful woman. She still comes to the group. She had contemplated suicide that night. And she saw our sign, 180-degree turn, and she came in. And she said before the group that it changed her life.
That is so wonderful. And those are the kinds of things that touch people and bring change and open our eyes to be grateful for. Nothing could be so drastic that we would want to end our life. And we certainly hope we help people in this way. And I think this Herencia magazine, which is Heritage magazine,
yes,
will bring great stories.
Absolutely.
What are in your plans? You know, I know you have great plans for the magazine.
We're going to expand. We're going to put an English page in it, and I will be writing it.
Yes.
And it'll be probably geared for seniors.
Great. And if they want to give you some ideas, you know, talking about heritage, I think about the stories of families about grandma and grandpa, or just some interesting things that you could write about our own El Paso families. And they could call you at area code 915.
Yes, correct.
248-7017.
Yes, ma'am.
To give you maybe some ideas of herencia, of our heritage, of senior stories.
Of highlighting a senior would be nice.
Yes.
Absolutely,
with pictures and, you know, just, I know you'll
stories.
Do a great job in stories.
Oh, thank you, Mary.
Yes, special interest stories. And that would be just a wonderful English page as well as what you do in Spanish and what Wesley does in Spanish.
Because we value our seniors. We really do. And they have to live with dignity and respect. And it's a way to honor them. So
yes. What other kinds of stories have you written about or have you read about in this?
How to forgive, to be thankful, to live one day at a time, to turn lemons into lemonade, as they say.
That's
stories like that.
Oh, that is so great. Thank you for staying with us. This particular topic that we're going to talk about is a little bit difficult for families. But these are choices and decisions that seniors and even young people need to make before the time comes. And that is making your arrangements about your services, your funeral services. And so we've invited Frank Ordaz, who is a representative of Dignity Memorial. And Frank stopped by my office some weeks ago, and I said, we've got to talk about it and on mature living. We've got to tell the community. So share with us, and thank you for being with us.
Thank you, Mary, for having me.
Share with us about this beautiful topic. I love the title of your presentation, and it's
Your Life, Your Legacy.
Your Life, Your Legacy.
And
tell me about that.
Basically, it is the importance of pre-planning, because as you know, there's a lot of things that go into a service, and most people wait till the time comes.
Yes.
And then family members, the survivors, are having to figure out how to fund this, how to pay for it.
Yes.
And so it's very important that we take time while we're alive to look at what we want, how we want to be remembered, and choose how we want to go.
Yes.
And at the same time, you protect your family, in a manner of speaking, because you take that financial burden off of them.
Yes.
You take that part that they don't have to deal with at the time that they're grieving, because grieving is a process that we have to go through.
Yes, and you can't think straight.
And you can't think, and that's the wrong time to walk into any funeral home and try to make a decision about what you want to buy, what you need to get for your parents.
What grandma and grandpa would have wanted, or what mom and dad would have wanted, or brother and sister, or whoever. And we need to think about our services, even the obituary, what we want.
Yes, what you want said.
Highlight.
How you want to be remembered is what all of this pre-planning is. We provide at Dignity Memorial what we call a personal planning guide.
Wonderful. Yeah.
And in here you write what you want and how you want it.
I need one of those.
and you leave it for your family so that they have it. So
yes.
They know what accounts you have, what they have to close in financial businesses. You can write your obituary, how you want, and who you want at your service, who you want presiding at your service.
You
a lot
have
of those things.
Available.
We have these available for our folks, our families that come to Dignity Memorial, to our funeral homes. We have 7 funeral homes, 8 soon to be here in January.
Which are they?
We have Martin East, West and Central. We have Hillcrest East, Hillcrest West, Crestview, Castor or Maxon on the northeast side, and there will be a new funeral home combination, which will be Evergreen Funeral Home and Cemetery.
Wow.
And then we have...
And you already mentioned the one that I had selected.
Yes.
And I pre-planned. But I haven't written anything. I haven't really, made arrangements for payment, and I paid it off. But
Which is a very important part of all of this, is that when the time comes, your survivors don't have to start looking for a method of pain.
Yes. And I can give them this handbook.
You can provide.
You say, can. Okay, this is your Christmas gift.
This is your gift for
stress free.
For mom. When the time comes, yes. And we even recommend that once you have this, once you sit down with one of our family planning counselors, and you fill this out, we keep a copy with your contract, with your paperwork, and that way, if your family loses it or misplaces it, that can't find it. We have it with all your paperwork.
Rick.
So when they come, everything is there for them.
Yes.
And all they do now is grief mom in the way that they,
yes,
without having to worry about what are we going to do for services.
Do you work with veterans? Sometimes veterans are homeless, and there are people that don't have anyone to make
decisions. We have two programs under Dignity Memorial. One is the veterans seminars, where we help veterans in also pre-planning. We have a veterans guide where they can order forms, the DD-214, very important document for us as veterans, because without it, the military won't move.
Yes.
You got proof that you were in service and that you were honorably discharged.
Yes.
So we have a particular guide that is for veterans so that they can get headstones if they're in a private cemetery, markers for that headstone, things that they will not get if they go in a private cemetery, that they will get at Fort Bliss.
Yes.
But also to understand that the VA doesn't cover everything.
Okay.
Because a lot of veterans are under the assumption that because they have the soldier's life insurance or they were retired from the military, that their funeral is taken care of.
Yes.
The only thing taken care of is the cemetery.
So
the funeral still has to come from that individual's pocket.
Yes,
and so
or the family.
Pre-planning goes into that.
Okay.
We also have the homeless veterans program that you mentioned, where at Martin Central is where that program is out of, and we provide a dignified service for any homeless veteran here in El Paso.
Amazing.
And it's actually through the nation, because we're a nationwide organization.
There's
about 2,300 funeral homes and cemeteries throughout the U.S. and part of Canada.
Yes.
So we're a large corporation.
You provide that dignified service for homeless veterans. Yeah, that's wonderful. Public Servants Program. What is that one?
Program is, and I brought you this because we didn't have it the last time we spoke.
Yes.
It's basically for any police officer, firefighter, medical emergency personnel that die in the line of duty. Dignity Memorial will provide a free funeral service to include a cemetery plot for them.
Yes.
as part of honoring their service to our community.
And that is part of your community service.
And that's part of our
commitment.
Community. Yes, ma'am.
The commitment.
It's Dignity Memorial.
You know, Frank, I know people will want to get your phone number because they'll want to call you. Where can they call you?
Right now, I can be contacted at Hillcrest Funeral Home, which is area code 915-598-3332. And I can be reached there, and I will be happy to direct anyone to any of our facilities here in El Paso, and our family counselors, service counselors, whatever they need that I am able to provide, and if not, I will get someone that could provide it for them.
And I know that we all have to go through this.
Yeah.
And it's something, it's like being born.
Yes.
You're born, and then you die. But,
life.
It needs to be stress-free for the family. And the reason that I decided to pre-plan my funeral is to allow my children and my family members not to be worried on that day, but to celebrate and to be together and make it something more enjoyable than
fighting. Sure, it is a celebration. It's a celebration of your life. of our lives.
Yes, a celebration of life.
And at that time, you want your family to grieve.
Yes, and remember, it's your life, your legacy. And thank you so much for being here with us. And
thank you, Mary.
Come back
it's
again.
A pleasure.
Yeah,
a pleasure.
It's always great to see you, Frank.
Thank you.
Okay, well, we'll be back with more Mature Living Guests. We have a wonderful program to talk to you about. And this is the Centro, the Mexican Women's Cooperative of the Centro.
Santa Catalina.
Mm-hmm. I couldn't find it on my notes.
Yeah.
And so I want to introduce all of you to Rachel Pineda, who is one of the board members of this 501c3 nonprofit organization, Centro Catalina. And of course, Sister Frances, thank you for joining us. Mm-hmm. Tell me about your wonderful program. I think it's going to be easy to convince people to assist in one way or another.
Okay. Centro Santa Catalina is actually a ministry, faith-based ministry, that started in 1996, and the women from the Colonia Pamphilo Natera, where the old garbage dump used to be in Juarez, these are very economically poor women. They got together, and two sisters by the names of Sister Donna Kustich and Sister, I think her name was Sister Ethel. They're Dominican nuns, and they both got things going, talking to the women. They first visited with the women to ask them what they wanted, what the women wanted. And as the women expressed their desires, then this Centro Santa Catalina was formed. And so it is faith-based, and they get they work in a cooperative 4 days a week, and then they pray on the fifth day, because it is a faith-based community.
Yes, so beautiful. How many women are now participating?
Well, I believe they would be in the neighborhood of probably, would you say?
19, but one is ill. So we're probably down to 18.
Yeah.
And Sister Ha, what do you want to say about this beautiful project that you're involved with?
Well, I was going to just kind of talk about the services that are offered. So Centro Santa Catalina is like the umbrella. And then under there, we have the co-op, which really is profit making and allows the women a salary into the house. It's not that much, but sometimes it's all that comes in. And then beyond the co-op, though, there were many children in the streets and nothing to do. Some children were the children of the women.
Yes.
So Sister Donna wanted them to be profitably using their time. So she started like a homework help program. Well, this has grown, and we have 120 children now from grades mm-hmm. 1 through 6. And in Mexico, some children go to school in the morning, so, you know, they're not there, but then they come in the afternoon. Mm-hmm. But all told, we have 120.
Amazing.
What's exciting, they get help with their homework. They do projects. They can play. They get a snack. But most important of all, there's a group in Juarez that's a social service group from the government called
FECHAC.
Mm-hmm. And they offered computers. Mm-hmm. So the children now have computers to work on, mm-hmm. printers, and are actually learning more in this program than maybe they have in the opportunity at their own school.
Mm-hmm.
So all of those, very beneficial. To me, the most important, they're off the street. The third, they have a garden program, uh-huh. and the women have little gardens. And so that's good.
Yeah.
And lastly, there's a program in Spanish, Valores Fe y Vida, but it's a program where the women participate and they talk about values, faith, and life. They come out more with dignity, self-esteem, independence, and you can just see over the years the growth in the women.
That is so wonderful.
So all bets off.
Oh my goodness. You have so many beautiful programs, and one of them is the cooperative. Right. Tell me about these little cards and about these beautiful, you can pick one up, sister, and show us.
If you talk, I'll be the holder.
Tell me.
Well, the women actually make these items, and they work together. There's about 18 to 20 women right now in the cooperative. They make their own decisions. They're buying the fabric from Michigan.
Mm-hmm.
And so this is the Mexican fabric, and they work together. Some women are cutting the cloth. Other women are sewing it.
Yes.
Other women are making the knots.
Uh-huh.
And other women are packaging the scarves, the rebozos, whatever they're making. They make purses as well. And they make placemats.
Oh, the placemats, mm-hmm. Yes. And each one
and
has
scarves.
A card, mm-hmm. which features a story
of one of the women. Yes.
Look at that beautiful
and
pink one as well.
And this is a lovely little mm-hmm. shawl or a small rebozo.
And these are very reasonably priced.
Very.
They help the cooperative. And where can they find these? How can people order from you?
Well, the office is located at 1207 Alabama.
Uh-huh.
Sister Maureen Gallagher is in charge. And it's always a good idea to call her on the phone because she goes to Juarez often back
yes.
and forth.
Yes.
And the phone number is 564-9003.
Yeah. On this side of the border.
It's on this side of the border. And she has all these items in her little basement there where she lives. She has all the items for sale.
So what are, and I'm running out of time here,
yeah.
but how can people help you aside from buying the products?
Well, I'll just say very quickly that if women sew and they have leftover material, they can put it in a bag, drop it off at Sister Maureen's. The women make many other table runners, other things, so scraps come in very handy.
Mm-hmm.
The other, we're always in need of school supplies for the children, pencil, notebook, eraser, crayons kind of thing, glue, and...
Oh my gosh, I just went to an estate sale,
and
there was so many materials, much material that elder, had.
Yes.
That could have been, I could have purchased it and then donated it. You see, oh gosh, maybe I can still get some. But what a beautiful mm-hmm. community service you are giving and helping the people in Juarez mm-hmm. that are the most marginalized, the economically poor, but rich
yes.
in love
yes.
and gratitude, I'm sure.
Yes.
Oh. Sister?
And we do have a website if anyone's got
yes, let's
computer.
Do it. Yeah, let's give the website.
Well,
if not, we'll put it
in the.
We're going to go ahead and put it on the screen here.
It Sister will be
Francis
there.
And mm-hmm. Rachel, thank you so much for coming. We've run out of time.
Yes.
But this is a time for giving, and you can give all year round to this Centro Santa
yes.
Catalina and with the sisters and Rachel and all the lay people that help. God bless you.
Thank you for bringing us this wonderful news.
LULAC District 4 of El Paso is beginning the planning and coordinating a student-parent conference. You know, El Paso is a great place to raise children, but we always have room for improvement. We want to make sure that our kids grow up to be productive citizens, that they're contributing, that they volunteer, that they realize that there's many dangers out there that they don't know about. And so we want to promote this conference to you. And so I've invited a couple of community partners that are going to be involved in the planning of this conference. Possibly will take place in the fall of 2017.
Thank you for being with us. This is Catalina Estala and, of course, Rebecca Hernandez. This morning I mentioned to you this conference, and your eyes lit up and you said, yes, we will be there to help. Tell me why it's important to you.
As a parent, I think it is very important that we inform our parents that are young parents, that have young children, children that are just starting, parents that don't know what to do, how to guide them and everything. I think this will be a fantastic way of getting all of our parents, you know, some information that they need.
Yes, and we're gonna have many partners. Volare is one of them for parents that have in their families children with disabilities, but there's so many professionals, such as your daughter, mm-hmm. a doctor, a medical doctor, role models. Mm-hmm. Talk about scholarships. Talk about the opioids problem. Tell me why you think it's important to get involved.
Absolutely. I kind of experienced that when my daughter was going to college. The opioids. A lot of the students were taking the opioids to stay up, to be able to maintain, because their lives are so busy and they have to study and they weren't being able to stay up, and so they would take the opioids, and some of friends suffered the consequences. Yes. So it is a problem. We also have it in the military, so we see that with our veterans, and so there is a problem, and hopefully we can bring it to light in this conference. Yes.
So if there's anyone out there that has a topic that they have expertise on that would help either parents or young teenagers, high school age, college age, even middle school, we have to start very early, that would like to present, they can call us. And I'm gonna give that phone number in a minute. If there's some parents there that want to participate and wanna register, this is gonna be a free conference. We're gonna get sponsors. We're going to get the ISDs, the superintendents, to jump in and send representatives and make sure the kids get bused to this conference that we're going to have in the fall. And so it's so important that you get involved, right? We can sit in the bleachers or we can get on the field and play.
Exactly.
And that's what we're asking for, a message that you'd like to send.
I would just like to tell all the parents that, you know, our children are not, any child is not, you don't get a child without a book to say or guidance of how you raise them. But when you have a child with a disability, it becomes doubled work.
Yes.
And if you can find somebody to help you, guide you, talk to them on what you are going through with a child with a disability, hey, come on board. Come join us.
Yes. And even some of these kids that are, you know, very knowledgeable of technology, they get in trouble with uploading pictures, and it creates problems, and there's cyberbullying. There's so many topics we can talk. There's gangs, you know, the peer pressure. We can talk about so many things that will help the kids to open their eyes, what not to do.
Absolutely.